Welcome aboard, everybody. This is Pittsburgh Penguins hockey, and tonight the unexpected hiatus from action ends for the Penguins as they hit the ice at Nassau Coliseum in Uniondale, New York, for their first of eight this year against the New York Islanders. And up front, Matt Barzell centering Anders Lee and Josh Bailey. The Penguins will move right to left across your radio dial here in this first frame. They're in their road whites, Islanders in their home blues, and we are underway on Long Island as the Pens ice the puck 12 seconds in. He works through center. Chops it forward, hoping for a teammate. It goes the other way, though. Out comes Dal Cole, left wing for Eberle at the left circle in the backhand. In on goal, he scores! Jordan Eberle, top shelf over Tristan Jarry, and the Islanders strike first. It's 1-0.
Josh, you know sometimes certain plays happen on the ice, and you're like, this is going to end up in our net. As soon as Drew O'Connor did not get this puck in, I was like, that's it. That's exactly what I'm talking about right there. That's what the Islanders feast on. It's a simple play. And when you're a fourth line player, if you have that play 100 times, guess how many times it has to go deep?
100.
100 times. That's unacceptable for a player like that that's looking for a spot on this team, is looking for ice time. It's a simple play. Just get the puck in deep, especially against the New York Islanders. And they ram it right down your throat. And sure enough, it's a guy like Eberle that comes in on his backhand. I thought Tristan Jarry was down a little bit too early there. And Eberle goes upstairs over the right shoulder of Tristan Jarry. It's 1-0, Islanders.
To the left side for Letty. Out in the neutral zone, it's Gensel. Back in his own end now for Joseph. Skates left wing for Gensel over the line. Drops it back for Joseph. Left circle towards the net. Shoots one. He scores! P.O. Joseph, top corner. And that's career goal number one for 73.
Welcome to the National Pojo. Oh, top shelf, baby. Right where Mama keeps the peanut butter. What a rocket. And I know you're thinking it, Mikey. I know you're listening. And Varlamov doesn't know what just hit him. Whether the cry or wind his watch. Pojo leading the rush. He'll give it go with Jake Gensel. And Sidney Crosby can't wait to scoop that puck up and deposit that in the paw of number 73, Pierre-Olivier Joseph, with his first National Hockey League goal. Congrats, kid.
Comes back to the right point for Marino. Center point for Matheson. It rolled on him, but Matheson able to recover there. He's a good skater and gets it ahead for Zucker. Sidestep, though, by Nelson. In come the Isles. Eberle with one goal already. Drops it back for Nelson. Into the body of Dal Cole to Nelson in the slot. Wrist shot stopped by Jarry. The rebound poked in by Eberle. And Jordan Eberle has two. The Islanders have two. Their lead back to one. It's 2-1 New York.
Well, Josh, you mentioned to me during our last break, well, the Penguins are losing a lot of 50-50 puck battles. I said, you're right. And that worries me a lot. And it's a mismanaged puck by Jason Zucker in the neutral zone. But then everything's okay. Penguins are back. But then Zucker loses another puck battle. And all of a sudden, it's in front of the net. And Jordan Eberle is all by himself. Where are the white jerseys? There is not one white jersey within 15 feet of Jordan Eberle. But I also don't like that Tristan Jarry was so passive. Doesn't get the stick in there, not disrupting Eberle, and he just shovels it past a surprise Tristan Jarry, and it's 2-1 Islanders.
Into the slot, stick checked as the puck rolls back out between the blue lines. Joseph gathers there for the Penguins. Quick passing up the left wing, finds Gensel. Into the right circle for Russ, cuts in. A shot there for Crosby is stopped by the right pad of Varlamov. And fires one that's gobbled up by Varlamov, who's himself has made a couple pretty good stops here early in the second period.
Save he made on Sid. And that give and go with Jake Gensel. Sid going from the backhand to the forehand. He probably saw an opening there, but man, if he held on another second, easy to say watching it here on the monitor, but holds on for another second, he might have been able to jam it between the skate blade and the post to the right of Varlamov.
Comes to Barzell, down the left wing, over the Penguin line. Puts on the brakes, just inside the line, maintains possession of the puck. Is he ever good at doing that? Puts it back to the point of shot there from Pella. Kicked out by the left pad of Jarry. The rebound, Jarry slides across and robs Josh Bailey from the right wing circle. And that one just went wide. Getting a stick on that was Zucker. He has it now. Up the right wing through center, 20 seconds left. Here's Zucker into the slot, lost it. Mayfield back out, couldn't clear. Kapanen to Malkin, left circle, shoots, he scores! scores. Evgeny Malkin from the left wing circle beats Varlamov up high. That was needed. It's 2-2.
Oh, that's vintage Gino right there. And you know who really lit the fuse on this line? Zucker. Jason Zucker was a man possessed out there. He lost the puck, but he hit the brakes, got back. Great job by Kapanen in there also to frustrate the Islanders for them to turn it over. And it was Kapanen, the one who retrieved the puck, gets it to Evgeny Malkin. Gino takes two strides. You know where that baby went? Exactly where P.O. Joseph went. Right upstairs, over the glove hand, under the bar. We're tied at two.
Evgeny Malkin. Well, you mentioned it earlier, Borky. Doesn't have to worry about it anymore. He's got a goal of 5-on-5, and that was a massive one for the Penguins.
Yeah, his first shot in the game. And now, for Gino, he's had a lot of success against Varlamov. That's 7 goals on 26 shots lifetime against Varley. We'll see if he can get a note down to the Penguins bench there in the old suggestion box. And be patient. You might get one chance here in the third period. Make the most of it.
Here's Crosby working for that chance on the near side wall. Into the slot for Gensel. Shoots one. He scores! Jake Gensel at the left wing circle. And the Penguins go up for the first time tonight. It's 3-2 Pittsburgh.
I told you this line's been sniffing it. Simple play. Turnover by Matt Martin on the forecheck. And the Penguins are hungry, hungry hippos. Brian Rust gets a puck to Sidney Crosby. Sid, like he's got three sticks out there, using his feet to corral a puck, get it to Jake Gensel, and Jake's able to go quickly from the skate to the stick, and with traffic in front by the New York Islanders screening their own goaltender, the quick release by Jake Gensel, stick side on the goaltender Varlamov, and the Penguins have their first lead of the game. It's now 3-2.
Battling for it there is Bluger. Instead, coming away with it is Andy Green. Up ahead for Martin. Bruce center, right wing feed for Cizikas. He'll chase it into the Penguin zone behind the net. Center's in front. A chance there for Clutterbuck. He scores. Cal Clutterbuck beats Tristan Jarry point blank from atop the crease. We're tied at 3.
Well, I've always thought this line was the identity of the New York Islanders because they're just a bunch of lunch pail guys. They don't take any shortcuts, and they can chip in offensively. And this is just as simple as it gets. Matt Martin with the simple dump-in. Cizikas with the great speed. Two Penguins, Joseph and Letang, both chase after Cizikas. That's hockey 101, boys. And I think Chris Letang needs to back off there. Joseph, his man is Cizikas. But Chris Letang comes all the way over, goes behind the net with Joseph to chase Cizikas. He throws it in front of the net. Nobody's covering Clutterbuck, and he's able to chip it past a surprise. Tristan Jarry, and we are tied at 3. Right in his feet, pushing him back into the goal. Still made the save.
Barzal with it again. Cross ice feed. Pulak, a shot stopped by Jarry. The rebound put in. Anders Lee in the blue paint, the captain for New York, makes it 4-3 Islanders. A power play goal with 2:44 to play.
Well, you had a bad feeling on the penalty by Bluger. That's an unforced error in my book. It just can't happen. A pretty good job by the Islanders. And it's just getting it towards the cage. Is that Pulak on the one-timer, I believe?
Yep.
It's a low, hard shot. Tristan Jarry makes the save, but it rattles between his skates. It just sits in the blue paint. Letang and Ruweedel are out there. They don't know where it is. The one guy who does, the guy that's always in front of the net. And that is Anders Lee, chips it into the wide open cage. And the Islanders have the lead back now, 4-3.
All the bodies on the far wall. Here's Letang, can't keep it in, and Clutterbuck finds it, fires wide for the empty net. 7 seconds to go. It's Letang behind the net for Malkin, 2 seconds, and Juan Malkin will blast at the length of the ice. It won't find the net. The horn will sound, and that will do it. So the New York Islanders defeat the Penguins by a final score of 4-3.